So, good morning, student. So, in last class, we discussed the different types of diffraction patterns like Phong number and Fresnel diffractions, and as well as we discussed the diffraction pattern due to the single slit. Today, we will derive the formula of the Phong number diffractions due to double slits. Right. So, Phong number diffractions due to double slits. In the last class, we start with the single slit. So today, we consider the double slits. Right. Okay. So now I draw a diagram. So let's the distance or the width of the slit is A. If the width of the slit is A and the center of this slit is O, then the diffraction pattern on a screen, let I consider the point P and one more point, that is P prime. Right? So if this angle is theta, and this distance is r, this distance from O to P prime is r, and this angle is theta, then in a single slit, let's I consider a small part, that is the dz. It's along the z axis, so for a particular specific part, the distance is dz. Then in a single slit, the expression of y will be k minus a by 2 plus a by 2 sine 2 pi p upon p minus r upon lambda plus z sine theta upon lambda dz. Basically, this is the equation of the wave which is propagating along the z directions. Then the total wave corresponding to this slit, the width of this slit is A. So the total width we consider, if it's a center part, so we consider from minus A by 2 to plus A by 2. That means for the whole width of A, the y will be given by this expression. Right. If we write these equations for the double slits, this is the equation for a single slit. Equations for single slit. Right. So if we write for the double slit, then this will be So for double slit, the wave resistance will be y k propagation constant minus a by 2 to plus a by 2, the same expressions, sine 2 pi t upon t minus r upon lambda plus z sine theta upon lambda dz plus minus d d minus a by 2 to d plus a by 2, the brackets, the same quantity, sine 2 pi t upon t minus r upon lambda plus z sine theta upon lambda dz. Basically, this d is the distance between the two slits. Now we consider the two slits. So in the first case, if we consider the single slit, so the total width is a. Now in the second case, if we consider the double slit, then the width will be minus a by 2 to plus a by 2, and the width from d minus a by 2 to plus d plus a by 2. D is the distance between two widths. Let's, if I have a two width a1 and another width a2, then d is the distance between these two widths, right? So if we integrate these equations from this limit, minus a by 2 to plus a by 2, and d minus a by 2 to plus d plus a by 2, the final wave equations will be y is equals to ka sine alpha. It's a simple integration from this limit, sine 2 pi t upon t minus r upon lambda minus k lambda 2 pi sine theta cos 2 pi t upon t minus r upon lambda plus z sin theta upon lambda d plus a by 2. So this is the final form of the wave equations y. So in that case, the intensity will be nothing but the square of this part. So the intensity will be, intensity I will be, I equals to 4 k square a square sine square alpha upon alpha square cos square beta. If I write the intensity due to the single slit, then the intensity due to the single slit is nothing but I equals to I naught sine alpha upon alpha whole square. Now you can compare between these two equations. In the first equation, which is for the single diffraction, single slit diffraction, the second is for the double slit diffractions. Now we have these additional terms, cos beta terms. Now what are the meanings of these symbols? The symbols are I naught is k square a square. K is propagation constant, a is the width of the single slit. So the value of I naught is k square a square. Alpha is pi a sine theta upon lambda. This is the value of angle alpha. Now we have additional angle beta. Then this additional angle beta will be, beta is pi b sine theta upon lambda. So this is the equations of intensity for double slit diffractions. double slit diffractions. This is for the single slit. This is for double slit. So if we compare the intensity of single slit as well as the double slit, then we can draw a diagram of single as well as the double slit. So very first I draw the intensity curve of a single slit. So you know that the intensity curve is this one for a single slit, right? Now I draw the intensity curve of a double slit. So the curve will be this one. Plus some additional interference waves. Right? So this is the intensity curve of the single slit, while this is the intensity curve of a double slit. Now the difference between these two plot is that now in this plot we have equally spaced interference maxima and minima. Now we have the equally spaced maxima and minima. You can clearly observe that we have equally spaced maxima and minima. Somewhere it's maximum, somewhere it's a minimum. So we have the equally spaced maxima and minima. While in that case, in the first case, we do not have an equally spaced maxima and minima. And intensity of double slit. It's a four time of single slit, right? So this intensity is the four times of the first one, means single slit. It's a four times intensity. So this is the main difference between the single slit diffraction pattern and the double slit diffraction patterns. This is the equation of the single slit, this is the equation of a double slit, and the corresponding intensity plots are this one. Right, now we derive a formula for the form of a diffraction for a n slit. This is for the two slits, so now we generalize this formula and derive the formula for the diffraction for the n slit. So if we have the n number of slits, then formula will be this one. So I'm writing far enough for diffractions for n slits. Far enough for diffractions diffractions for n slit and slit. For now, for diffraction for n slit, intensity will be I equal to k square a square sine square alpha upon alpha square sine square n beta upon sine square beta. This is the intensity formula of n slit diffractions. where n beta is n pi d sine theta upon lambda, where n is the total n number of the slits, d is the space between two consecutive slits, and the beta is 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi and so on, and n beta is 0, pi, 2 pi and so on. So tell me the maximum intensity conditions for n slits. So what will be the maximum intensity conditions? The maximum intensity means this intensity. This will be the maximum at only two conditions, if alpha tends to 0 and beta tends to 0. So I am writing, if alpha tends to 0 and beta tends to 0, in that case then I will be k square a square, which is the maximum intensity of n slit diffractions. I use to k square a square. Now what will be the intensity of principal maxima? The principal maxima when the angle is 0. So what will be the intensity of this principal maxima? So next we derive the intensity for the principal maxima. So I am writing the intensity of principal maxima of principal maxima right when beta tends to n pi. Remember this condition, when beta tends to n pi, what will be the value of this intensity? This, the value will be the intensity of the principal maxima. So now put the condition beta tends to n pi in this expression. So in that case, if I substitute the beta tends to n pi, this factor will be limit beta tends to n pi sine n beta upon sine beta. Now so this will be d upon d beta sine n beta. To find out the solutions, we take the first derivative of numerator as well as the denominator. So d upon d beta sine n beta and d upon d beta sine beta, right? So if we do this exercise and put the value beta tends to n pi, we got the value plus minus n. So now substitute this value in this expression, that intensity I will be k square a square sine square alpha upon alpha square plus minus n, multiply by plus minus n, multiply by plus minus n. So this is the intensity of the principal maxima. This is the intensity of a principal maxima of n slit diffraction pattern, right? So very first we derive the intensity expressions for single slit, then we derive the intensity expression for the double, and we finally generalize this formula and write the intensity expression for n slit diffraction patterns. Now we try to find out the missing order in double slit diffraction patterns. Missing order in the double slit diffraction pattern. missing order. In a double slit diffraction pattern. Right. So before we start this topic, let me introduce with some constant. You know, A is the width of slit. This is the width of slit. B is separations between slit. So A is the width of the slits and the B is the separation between slit. So basically the missing order is nothing but if we vary these two parameters A and B, some of the interference term will be missing in the expression, which is known as the missing order in a double slit diffraction. So basically we just vary this parameter A and B, so sometimes some order will be missing in terms of an interference as well as in terms of a diffraction. So now we derive the missing order terms. So we know that direction of interference, direction of interference maxima, the direction of interference maxima is given by these expressions A plus B sin theta is equal to n lambda. A plus B sin theta is equal to n lambda. Bragg's law. So this is the directions of a interference maxima. A is the width of slit, B is the separation between the slits. N is the number of order, n may be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. And lambda is the wavelength. So same as it is, directions of diffraction. Directions of diffraction will be A sin theta equals to P lambda. A sin theta equals to P lambda. P is again maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Lambda is the wavelength. So basically the difference between the interference and diffraction is in these terms. Now in the interference we introduce A plus B, while in the diffraction we introduce only the width of a slits, A sin theta. So we have the two equations, 1 and equation number 2. So in the next we give different conditions and find out the value of N and P. Right, so let's consider A equals to B, that means the fringe slit width is equals to the separations between the slits. So the first condition is when A equals to B. When A equals to B. First, when A equals to B. So in that case, the first equations will be 2A sin theta is equals to n lambda. The first equation will be 2A sin theta is equals to n lambda. And the diffraction equation will be as it is, A sin theta is equals to P lambda. This is interference equations. The second one is the diffraction equations. 2a sin theta equals to n lambda, a sin theta equals to p lambda. Now from these two equations we derive one relations. So now I divide these two equations. So this will be 2 is equals to n by p, or we can write n is equals to 2p. So if p is equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on, if p is equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on, then n will be 2, so put p is equals to 1, so n will be the 2, p is equals to 2, so this will be the 4, 4p is equals to 3, this is 6 and so on. Thus 2, 4, 6 will be missing in the diffractions. 2, 4, 6 will be the missing in a diffraction pattern. Therefore, order 2, 4, 6 will be missing in the diffraction. This term will be the missing in a diffraction. Right. Next condition is when 2a equals to b. Second condition. When 2a equals to b. And our standard equations are a plus b sin theta is equals to n lambda and a sin theta is equals to p lambda. So now substitute the value 2a equals to b and derive the relations. So the interference equation will be 3a, b equals to 2a, so 2a plus a, 3a sin theta is equals to n lambda. Interference equations and the diffraction equations is a sin theta is equals to p lambda. So again divide equation first by the equation second, then 3 is equals to n by p, 3 is equals to n by p, or we can say if p equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on, then n will be 3, 6, 9, this one. So now in this case, if 2a equals to b, the missing order in the diffractions are 3, 6 and 9, means number 3, number 6 and number 9 diffractions order will be missing in the diffraction pattern. Next, if a plus b equals to a, last condition, when a plus b equals to a, then a plus b a equals to a, in that case b will be 0, b will be 0, so all the order of the interference maxima will be missing. All the order of interference maxima will be missing in this condition when a plus b equals to a. So the in this exercise, we found the different missing order for the different conditions. So now, on the base of this exercise, we try to give the answer of a numerical problem. And the numerical problem is, find the missing order. Example, find the missing order missing order 4 a double slit, 4 a double slit fan of our diffractions for a double slit fan of our diffractions pattern. If slit width, if the slit width are 0.16 millimeter and they are 0.8 millimeter apart from each other, right? So we have to find out the missing order for these conditions. The slit width is 0.16 and the B is 0.8 millimeter. So A is 0.16 millimeter and B is 0.8 millimeter. Now convert millimeter into the centimeter. In that case, A will be 0.016 centimeter and B will be 0.08 centimeter. Right. So now write the equations corresponding interference and corresponding diffractions. So interference equation is interference part is A plus B sin theta equals to n theta n lambda, and diffraction part is A sin theta P lambda. So the value will be, just divide this two equation, A plus B sin theta equals to A lambda divided by A sin theta is equals to B lambda. So if we divide these equations, so this will be A plus B by A is equals to N by P. Now put the value, A is equals to 0.016 and B is equals to 0.08. So if we put the value, then this will be 0.016 centimeter plus 0.08 divided by A, 0.016 is equals to N by P. So if we solve this equation, then N by P is 6. N by P equals to 6, so the missing order is 6. N by P equals to 6. So in the same manner you can solve one more numerical exercise. We just change the value of this slit width and the distance between the slits. So here I stop. Next we will explain the same exercise with some different numericals. Thank you.